in.
Sir, I've got the Pope on line one. He wants to know whether the speech he gave on World Peace yesterday was alright.
Tell him I'll call him back. I'm busy right now.
Very good, sir.
You know, this is ridiculous. Tomorrow is going to be exactly the same as today, and yesterday, and the day before that. Honestly, though, nothing spontaneous happens anymore. You know, Peter, I think it's about time we all had a day off. I wonder, would anyone actually notice if I just took this file and chucked it in the bin? What do you think, Peter?
I really don't know, sir.
It was easy. Peter, spread the word. Tomorrow's cancelled. Everyone gets the day off.
Wake up on Sunday morning. Everything feels so boring. Is that where it ends? With your life through a lens. Hair is the new hat, brown is the new black. She shouldn't wear this, he shouldn't wear that. Pleasure, leisure, maybe mine a double measure with friends. A fashion time is down, equal bodies. Who lasts the longest, who tries the hardest? Pleasure, leisure, make mine a double measure with friends. Just because I ain't double barreled don't mean I haven't traveled well. Can't you tell? Oh no, it's quite appalling. Your conversation's boring as hell. Oh well, wake up on Sunday morning and everything feels so boring. Is that where it ends? With your life will end.
Jesus, it's quiet.
This latest exclusive from Hello Magazine. Kevin Carter, the new and uglier Tom Cruise, has entered the building, finally.
Mr. Carter, have you found any acting work yet? Nobody snapped you up for a star role in a blockbuster movie? No?
Crying shame.
Your last piece was inspiring. What was it again? Oh yes, I remember. You were in a shampoo advert for what? 5 seconds.
In business news, Waterhouse Systems has announced they're to lay off 200 staff at their headquarters in Bletchley. The move comes days after the company has announced they've gone into administration. A spokesperson for the company said that the move, while regrettable, was necessary to keep the company afloat. Sport now, and the MK Dons suffered a humiliating 6-0 defeat last night at home.
Home sweet home. What a day. Some sleep. Thank you.
the hell? Where am I? Okay. This is just bizarre. How did I get here? I know this looks bad, but
get
I
out.
Just don't know.
Get out,
okay,
right
okay,
now!
I'm going, okay?
Out of my house!
I'm sorry.
And stay out!
Come on, you're making a big mistake. Sitting around ain't gonna solve anything. Thanks a lot, God.
Your prayer will be answered shortly. Please hold.
Yes, somewhere.
Thank you for calling God. Your prayer will be answered shortly. Please hold. That one. That's it. Thank you for calling God. Your prayer will be answered shortly. Please hold. Thank you for calling God. No, sorry, mate. You got the wrong number. Yeah, just dial 666 and ask for Satan. No problem. Goodbye. Thank you for calling God. Your prayer will be answered shortly. Please hold. Thank you for calling God. Your prayer will be answered shortly. Please hold. We've got prayers coming in even faster now. America's just woken up and the phones are going mad.
Oh, I can't believe this. What are they all complaining about? Yesterday wasn't going to be anything special. Why's everyone got their knickers in such a twist?
I have an idea, sir. I think maybe all of these people are waking up in situations which took place as a direct result of you cancelling yesterday.
But that's impossible.
Check the file, sir. It should still be in your waste paper bin.
Well, this can't be happening. It's against all physical laws.
Since when did we care about physical laws, sir?
Fair point. But look at this. There are events in this file that I don't remember being there.
I was right then, sir.
Yes. There's nothing else for it. I'm going to have to refund yesterday.
Can you do that, sir? I mean, won't that disrupt the natural flow of time?
You weren't so bothered about the natural flow of time when I told you you were getting yesterday off. Remember who you're talking to.
Yes, of course. Sorry, sir.
Besides, there's nothing else I can do. I can only hope that by refunding the day, the mortals will at least know what happened in the last 24 hours and will be able to cope. When I'm finished, I want you to take this letter and send it to every single mortal on the planet.
Yes, sir. I'll dig out the address book.
Cold coffee. Well, that sums up my day. Kevin Carter. Heaven Incorporated. And God saw everything that he made, and behold, it was very good. Genesis 1:31. From the office of God.
People of Earth, I am God. I am writing to you to apologise for the monumental cock-up that I made today. I cancelled yesterday in order to give everyone in heaven the day off, and I really didn't think any of you would notice, but obviously you're all more intelligent than I gave you credit for. So, as an apology, I'm going to refund the day you all missed tomorrow. Normal service will be resumed the day after. I apologise for any inconvenience this may have caused you, particularly if you're one of the people who died yesterday and woke up dead this morning. Right, so I can only imagine how bad that must feel, not knowing how you popped your clogs. Anyway, I'm sorry, and hope that you can all find it in your hearts to forgive me. Just like I have forgiven you for your sins over the past few thousand years. Yours faithfully, God.
Yours faithfully, God. Bloody junk mail.
Bloody junk mail.
Yeah, definitely. So, yeah, what's this letter from God about everyone received yesterday, yeah? You know, could God send it really? I mean, is that possible? Religious groups are sceptical and dismiss the letter, calling it a hoax. I want to hear what you think. So, if the letter isn't from God, then who is responsible? We've got an email from Steve who says, I think it's a publicity stunt by the Stop the War.
Idiot! Where did you get your license out of the cereal packet? You again!
Oh, this is awkward.
Awkward just doesn't cut it. What were you doing in my house yesterday?
Well, there's definitely a reasonable explanation for all of this.
There'd better be.
It's just I can't actually remember it right now.
Isn't that convenient? What do you do? Get drunk, break in the back door, and then kip on the sofa? Who do you think you are?
Well, for all I know, I might have done. I mean, I might have got drunk and kipped on your sofa. And who I think I am, I'm Kevin. And I assume you're Shirley. Okay. I've had a thought. Did you get one of them letters yesterday?
Don't tell me you believe that rubbish.
No. But it would definitely explain a few things.
Oh, God. I was going to kill you, but it's obvious that you're completely mental. So I'm going to let you off.
Wow, I feel very special. Yeah, I'll give you a hand.
Not a complete invalid.
Okay. Okay, I'll phone an ambulance for you
no,
then.
No, I don't need one. But you will soon if you don't sod off.
All right, how about I give you a lift then?
I'm not going to trust you with my well-being.
Well, it looks like you've got a choice to make here. You can either let me phone an ambulance for you, or you can get in my car and I'll give you a lift to the hospital. Now, take your time, because me, I've got all day.
Oh, any funny business, and I'll punch your lights out.
Hooray, common sense prevails. Come on. Can I get your bag?
Sorry.
Car keys.
Lovely. Let's get a bit of radio.
Oi! What are you doing?
I was turning on the radio.
Right. Radio. Yeah, of course.
Right, so. Which way is it to the hospital?
What?
I'm only joking. Oh, please. I mean, you only have internal bruising. It could have been much worse.
Don't I never.
You know, I know this sounds a bit forward and everything, but how about I take you out for a drink, just to say sorry?
Fine, but that's it. And then you're out of my life.
Sounds fair enough to me.
Good.
So, do you any good clubs?
One drink, she said. One bloody drink.
You know what's amazing? I've had so much to drink, but I am completely in control of myself. Who put that card there? The government. The government should get that sorted.
Yeah, yeah, now you mention it, they probably will.
Hello. You look familiar. Do I know you?
That's a lamppost.
You're like, wow. Is it?
Keys have gone walkabout.
Do you want to come inside? You can give them my stuff.
Nah, you're alright. I'll call a locksmith. I'll tell you what, yeah.
I don't think locksmiths are going to want to come out, but this time not.
Nah, it's fine. Yeah, he'll come out. It's alright.
No! Come in! After all you've done for me.
I ran you over.
Yeah, well, we all make mistakes. Come inside. I'll find you a blanket.
You sure?
Yeah, certainly.
Hey, it's Kevin. This is awkward. Kevin, yeah, the guy that ran you over. Yeah, yeah. Hiya, I was just wondering, Shirley, that, I don't know, this is a bit to say, but, well, are you free for lunch today?
There we are. It's the last prayer that involves this horrible business. I think we've all learned something from this, Peter.
Yes, sir. There is one thing that's bothering me slightly, though.
What?
Won't time be a bit cross when he discovers you've been meddling with the natural order of things?
Look, can you step into my office for a moment, please? I want to work.